Че му е огромно задоволство денеска гостин во студиото ни е Маркус Гињард, најдобриот играч на работнички, воедно и освојувач на NCAA лигата во 2009 година. Today my guest is the swingman from Robotnički Skopje, Marcus Gignard, winner of the NCAA championship in 2009. It's my pleasure, Marcus, and thank you for coming.
Thanks for having me.
First of all, congratulations for the win against the MZ Skopje yesterday. You know, that's the biggest derby and like most important basketball match in our country. How do you feel here in Macedonia?
I feel great. It's been a great experience for me being here since September of last year, playing for Robotnički. Playing well and you know, really putting ourselves in a position to win the championship. So everything's been great.
Marcus, how did you fell in love with this game and why did you choose basketball?
I think it really came from my mom and my brother. They were the ones who taught me how to play basketball from a very young age. And since then, I've just been in love with the game. I've always loved playing. And here I am today.
Were they also playing professionally?
They weren't playing professionally, mm-hmm. but my brother played in college. My mom was a all-conference player in high school. So I had some good basketball genes.
Actually, your brother was your coach, right?
Yes, in high school. He coached me for 2 years.
Okay, Marcus, tell me more about yourself. Where did you grow up? And something more about the high school days and the college days.
So
I think that's the most important in your basketball career.
Absolutely. I grew up just outside of Washington, D.C., just south of Washington in Virginia, where I played my high school basketball, where my brother coached me for 2 years. We were state champions 3 times. Then I went on to play at the University of North Carolina, where Michael Jordan went to school.
Tell us something, yeah.
Exactly.
Tell us something more
so
about
most
it,
people know UNC because that's where Michael Jordan went to school. But that was a great experience as well. I played with a lot of great players, a lot of guys that are still playing in the NBA today. And we were able to win a national championship in 2009. And since then, I've started my professional journey, which started in 2010.
Do you know any basketball players, like famous NBA players, who you went in school with?
Yes, I do. So currently, let's say Danny Green.
Also, Vince Carter was
there a little before me, but Danny Green played with me. Ed Davis, who plays for the Trailblazers. Wayne Ellington, who plays for the Heat. Ty Lawson, who plays for the Wizards right now. There's a lot of guys for sure.
So it's one of the most popular universities there, right?
Absolutely.
How was the experience winning the NCAA title, the same trophy that Michael Jordan won in the same college, actually?
It was an incredible experience, something that's very hard to put into words, but, you know, we played a game in front of 72,000 people. It was an experience, like I said, that I'll never forget, and it was just amazing.
Actually, I don't think that people in Macedonia understand how big is the college basketball in USA.
It's very similar to how fans treat football in Europe. I mean, there's hundreds of thousands of fans for every university. And so, you know, March Madness and the NCAA tournament is really a big time for basketball.
Now let's talk about your professional career. If I'm right, you were 2 times really close to the NBA league.
Let's say close. So
okay, in 2010 you were undrafted, and after you were playing in the NBA Development League.
Right. So
I have some percentage of 33% of the players actually who play in the Development League. Yeah.
Exactly. Well, I started in 2010. I had a tryout with the Charlotte Bobcats at the time.
You were playing in the Summer League.
In the Summer League, mm-hmm. but just before Summer League started, I decided to take a job in Europe. So I came to Europe and was in Europe for 3 or 4 years, and then played in the D League. For 1 season in New York, which didn't quite work out for me the way that I wanted, but they were both still great experiences to feel like you were just on the doorstep, you know, to making it to the next level.
Can you make a difference between the European basketball and the basketball that you were playing in the USA?
I think that here in Europe, the game is much more, I don't know, much more fundamental, much more skill-oriented.
Yeah,
much more team-oriented, and in the NBA, there's a lot more athleticism, a lot more one-on-one basketball, but it's still very, very good basketball and very high levels, you know, in both ways.
Is there any difference, like, in the training?
I think the training is probably pretty similar, mm-hmm. but, again, you know, just the bodies in the NBA are just completely different. You know, the like I said, the athleticism, the height, the speed is just so much greater in the NBA.
Do you have any basketball idols? And what's your favorite team, actually? the most difficult question.
Sadly, my favorite team is the Washington Wizards, because that's
hometown.
My hometown team. We always play very well. We generally make it to the playoffs, but we don't normally go farther than that. For idols, I really grew up loving Michael Jordan. This was the perfect time for me to see one of the greatest players play. And I've always enjoyed watching the great players, Michael and Kobe and now LeBron, and you know, just so many great players out there. I just like watching the best players.
You also like to help people and to educate young kids about basketball. Do you have any other plans about helping the community here? And you can also mention the stuff that you were doing here.
So far this year, I was able to meet with two different organizations, with October 11th and with the SOS Children's Village. Got some time to spend with those kids, play basketball with them, talk to them just about dreams and reaching their goals and being motivated and things like that. I also had the help of the junior team from Rabotnitsky, who helped me pull together some presents to give to SOS Children's Village for Christmas, which was great. I've had a basketball camp in the U.S. coming on 7 years now. This is our seventh year with the basketball camp, and I've always been around people who gave back to the younger kids, and so for me it was just very important to spend time with the youth and to try to motivate them and try to encourage them to, you know, to do their best and to be, they're going to be the next generation of leaders in the world.
That's true.
So it's been great for me.
Thanks a lot for helping the community. What is your opinion about Macedonian basketball? But be honest, please.
Yeah, absolutely. I think everybody here knows that this year hasn't been the greatest year for Macedonian basketball. I don't know how this league is generally, but we've had a very good showing in the, let's say, top 5-6 teams, and the bottom half of the league hasn't been so great. But I think with the teams that are going to be fighting for the championship, I think there's a lot of competitiveness, and it's going to be very, very interesting, you know, going into the playoffs.
Do you think that you have a big chance winning the championship this year?
Absolutely. I think that there's no question that we can achieve anything that we want to achieve this year. And if we stay focused, we stay healthy, and we keep our eyes on the prize, I think that we'll bring the championship back to Rabotnitsky.
Markus, that's everything for my questions. Thank you for being my guest today. I wish you good luck winning the title this year.
Thank you very much.
All the best, Markus.
Thanks.
Thank you very much.